Hello, welcome to News Labour Sports. I'm Moses Echodu, and I'll be bringing you nothing but the very best of the sports stories. And today we're going to be focusing primarily on that transfer window where we've seen Manchester United, Arsenal, Man City, Chelsea, Real Madrid, Barcelona all getting involved in serious training, trades that we'll be looking at bolstering on their different teams. Of course, we cannot go without mentioning that Aston Villa have been one of the busiest teams in this transfer window. They have bought close to 8 to 9 players, and they remind me so much of Fulham that went ahead and bought almost a whole new squad altogether. But guess what? It did not work out for them, as they were later on relegated in the season. So the big question for us today is, will Aston Villa survive with the new signings that they have made, or will it be another case of Fulham getting relegated this time around? Of course, so much dynamics can always happen. Of course, you could get these players, they click right at the moment, give you fantastic results, and make sure that you stay in the Premier League. Like we keep saying, it's about getting that pass mark of 30 to 40 points. After that, you just leave it all to the gods of football to be able to determine for you. Now, we want to get started with that. That is Chelsea. Christian Pulisic, a massive signing for them, because he had a fantastic campaign with that Borussia Dortmund in German Bundesliga. He's great with his ball, he's fast on his feet, he has bags of trickery, and knows where the net is, so he can score the goals for Chelsea. And then of course you have to look at so many other dimensions that he brings into this team, and so there is so much that he can actually come with that to give to this Chelsea side, and he will definitely fill up that gap that was left behind by Eden Hazard. Of course, we cannot really say that he's going to leave all the gaps. It's going to completely fill up the gap that was left by Eden Hazard. However, what we can say is that he's going to be able to fill up some of the gaps that were left by Eden Hazard, and hopefully the likes of Hudson-Odoi, the likes of Tammy Abraham, the likes of Willian can be able to step up and give the same result as well. And of course, they got also Kovacic from Real Madrid, a signing that they made. Remember that Kovacic has had with Chelsea on a loan, and so what they just happened is that they chose to sign him permanently and to try and beef up on that midfield, which I think for me was a brilliant idea by the Chelsea management. Man City, they went ahead and got Rodri, a massive signing for them, because one, Rodri comes with bags of experience playing under Diego Simeone, has knowledge about the defensive kind of play. That is something that Man City will be looking at, because with Fernandinho getting into the latter stages of his career, you're thinking that probably they need someone fresher and younger that can be able to step up to the challenge. And Rodri can be able to play the kind of system that that is Pep Guardiola loves to play. And so those are some of the juggles that we'll look at see if at the end of the day they will pay off. But for Rodri, I believe that it will pay off. He knows how to tackle, he knows how to intercept, he knows how to pass the ball, something that Guardiola loves to see a lot in all his players. So I believe that is going to be a massive signing for them. At Manchester United, though, they got Aaron Wan-Bissaka, one of the best right backs of last season. He'll come into this Manchester side, step right into the starting 11, because guess what? He has speed. He has the ability to cross that ball efficiently. He knows how to track back, something that Ole Gunnar Solskjaer will be appreciating so much with his signing. So you're thinking that probably it's the kind of signing that they will want to have at the end of the day. Then of course they also got Daniel James from Swansea City, and so he's the kind of player that will be able to come in there, give him the results as well. He can run behind defenders, he can be able to sign as can be able to run behind defenders, can be able to cross that ball, can be able to score goals as well, and also he's also good on the dead ball situation. So the other players that they're looking at, Paulo Dybala, massive signing if they can get him, because he knows how to score the goals, can run behind the defenders, good on the set pieces as well. 25 years of age, has probably what, 7-8 years that he can still offer to Manchester United if they can be able to acquire his services at the end of the day. Harry Maguire, a player that they will definitely need, because in that defensive lineup you have Phil Jones, you have Chris Smalling. Not to say anything, but those are not the kind of players that Manchester United should be having if they are going to continue contending for the Premier League, or even are looking to get into the Champions League places at the end of the day. At Arsenal, Nicolas Pepe, one of the best players in the French league, has the ability to run behind defenders, good on the set pieces, scored over 22 goals for Lille as they were running behind PSG in the French League One. Of course, 9 of those goals were from the penalty spot, but at the end of the day, all a goal is a goal. So probably wait and see if he can be able to replicate the same things at Arsenal. Arsenal also did go ahead and got themselves, that is, Dani Ceballos from Real Madrid, a box-to-box midfielder that should be able to come and play into this Arsenal system. Already we've seen glimpses of him in the preseason, and he has shown that he can be able to, you know, to tussle it out with the big boys in there. So wait and see if it can actually materialize for Arsenal and not be another case of Danish worries for them at the end of the day. Wolverhampton got themselves Patrick Catron from AC Milan, a good signing, good striker. Wait and see if he can actually start, you know, getting the goals, because alongside players like Jimenez, alongside players like Diego Jota, alongside players like Moutinho, you're thinking that probably Catron could be one of those players that they can add down to them. So they also went ahead and got themselves Vallejos from Real Madrid on loan, a good centre back that should be able to come into the side and help, you know, in cases of trying to add up in the numbers for them. And then of course we go to the big guns, that is in Real Madrid. They got themselves several players, but among them is Eden Hazard. We all know what he has been doing at Chelsea. We've seen him play, being played by Zinedine Zidane at, that is, Real Madrid in the preseason. However, it has not really ticked off the way many had anticipated. But we're to see what Zinedine Zidane can be able to do with him, and see if he can actually start creating the goals, scoring the goals for Real Madrid, just like he was doing at Stamford Bridge for Chelsea. And the other player that they didn't get also was Jovic from Frankfurt. Brilliant young striker, but the challenge that they face now is that he's currently out injured, and so he'll be coming back when the season has begun, and hopefully he can be able to come in there and help Karim Benzema in looking for the goals, because we know that on the other flip side they have likes of Vinicius Junior, Rodrigo, who can be able to create the chances for them, with midfield maestros in Toni Kroos and Luka Modric. There's so much more that they can be able to do. Their defensive setup, though, needs to be reorganized if they are going to challenge Barcelona for the Spanish La Liga. Barcelona have so far signed Antoine Griezmann to create another triplet of players that they can depend on. Remember that previously they had Neymar, Messi, and Suarez. Now they have Griezmann, Messi, and Suarez. However, Messi and some other players are trying so much to push for the resigning of the Brazilian, that is Neymar from PSG, who has already told that PSG that he's not going to play for them this coming season because he wants to go back to the Camp Nou. Probably he feels that he's not really been able to, you know, to exploit his talents and his, you know, kind of football in France the way he had wished to, because of the lesser competition that is in France. However, at the end of the day, we all wait to see what happens and who will sign a Neymar. There are so many transfers that are going to be happening between now and next week. However, before the Premier League starts on the 8th of August, the window will be closing and we'll be bringing you all the big stories and which signings are going to make the difference for which team. Me, Moses Echodo, and the entire News Libre Sports team, it's peace out. Don't forget to click the subscribe button and be able to see all the different stories that we'll be sharing with you. Peace. And goodbye.